Not the best opening hand. It's nice to see the Ensoul artifact in here, but just like Steel Overseer, it costs 2 mana. As champion, I'm really a long way off of casting. I mean, Steel Overseer is a huge card in this matchup. And I am on the draw, so I have 2 draw steps to find the land. But I think a random 6 card hand is gonna be better. Because the probability of me missing like two lands or 2 mana sources in a row is still fairly high. I mean, it might be 30% or something. And even if I do hit both of my lands, the hand is okay, but if he has an answer to my Steel Overseer, like a Dismember, I'm still probably losing. So I'd rather just mulligan. Feels a bit safer. Here, well, at least we have another mana source in Mox Opal, and then another one in Mox Opal. But yeah, this is Edge Champion and Cranial Plating, which is a powerful combo against this deck. I'm definitely keeping. This might be like a 3 turn clock together. That's good enough. It's a game plan. Edovile, arguably the best card on turn 1 for him to have. Question is, do I already want to cast Edge Champion here? Kind of lose my Mox Opal. I think the answer to that is yes. It's better to just get some additional things on the battlefield. This way I can already attack for 2 on the next turn. And if I draw a land, then that's even better. Yeah, if I draw a land or another Mox Opal, then I can just immediately put plating on here. Get in for a ton. Assuming that he doesn't leave open a Mutavolt, which is kind of a good answer to the Edge Champion. It's a good start. Come on, land. Dismember. I guess it's not the worst. Because if he wants to try to block with Mutavolt, I can just kill it. But it's also not the best. Do I attack with Edge Champion? On the plus side, I get to deal 2 damage. Which might even be a full turn of the clock. Since, let's see, I will have 6 artifacts on the next turn, making this an 8 power guy. I might even have 7, depending on what I draw. Possibly making this a 9 power guy. So yeah, it could be a full turn of the clock if I deal 2 damage here. The downside is that if he has something like Curse Catcher and then a Lord, I lose my opportunity to block and stave off some damage. So I might be trading 2 for against, well, possibly 5 damage. But I think that's worth the risk. Also, if the game goes too long, then you can just build up with stuff like Master of Waves and Tassa and, I don't know, have a devastating Hercules Recall or whatever. So trading 2 damage for what might be 3 now, that's actually fine. Besides, I wouldn't be able to block anyway, as it turns out. All merfolks have island walk. The interesting thing is that this is an artifact land still. It's an artifact land island, but it still counts for the cranial plating. He didn't leave his Mutavolt untapped, so I don't have to worry about that right now. I'm happy about that. Yep, so now I did draw like an artifact making this indeed a two-turn clock. With 2 damage from the last turn. Could be important. If something really crazy happens, I still have this member up. But we'll see what happens. Maybe I should have re-equipped this plating to an Ornithopter so it could block his master in case. I don't know, he does something. Not sure. Well, I guess it doesn't matter because this now also has Island Walk. Yeah, just taking it and hoping that the dismember on the Mutavault will be good enough. I definitely need to play this because that plays around Vapor Snag on my Ornithopter. So might as well attack with the Ornithopter as well, I guess. What can he have? The only things I can think of are, well, trying to work with Mutavault or a Hercules Recall. Against Hercules Recall, I might actually still be able to get back. I mean, I lose my island so I can block his creatures, and I have Mox Opal to rebuild quickly. I don't think it really matters whether or not I attack with the Ornithopter here. Either he has something good or he doesn't. I guess I can play around Mana Leak. Not sure they typically play Mana Leak. It seems unlikely. The downside is that if I just, I mean, if I play around Mana Leak, I don't pay life. Sorry, if I play around Mana Leak, then I pay life to this member, meaning that if he has Hercules Recall, I'm probably just dead. Whereas if I just tap 3 mana nicely, then I don't lose any life. And if he has Hercules Recall, then what happens is I play Ornithopter, Mox Opal, tap it for a Springleaf Drum, block his Silvergill Adept, go down to 4 life. Because I don't have an island anymore. Next turn, I play Citadel, play S Champion. No, then I'm still dead, so I can't actually beat Hercules Recall anyway. So I might as well play around the Mana Leak, which I don't know they actually play, but might as well. No. Ooh, Spell Pierce. He has 2 Spell Pierce. That would suck. But yeah, this way also plays around the Spell Pierce that they apparently do play, so this worked out. He's gonna need another Spell Pierce or the Hercules Recall. If he doesn't, then he's just dead. Even a Vapor Snag on an Ornithopter is not gonna do it. Then I still get in for 9 damage with my Edge Champion. As I said. So I think that's it. Beat the good matchup in Merfolk, despite them having some disruption. Okay.